Let's take a look at how you can build a Copilot in Copilot Studio. This video is part of my Copilot Studio Essentials series, where we cover all of the core skills in under 10 minutes. Everything starts here, copilotstudio.microsoft.com, and you can sign up for a free trial with your work or school account to do everything I'm showing you here. So the first experience here is that you can describe your Copilot to create it. You're actually going to use a Copilot to build a Copilot. So I'm going to start here by saying, I want to build a Copilot that should provide information about health conditions and treatments and advice for healthy living. And we send that prompt to get started. Now, this is going to take you through a chat experience, giving you a prompt each time to help build out the essential pieces of your Copilot. And then I'm going to show you where all of that lands. So the first thing here, it says, do you have any instructions for how your Copilot should assist? For example, a specific tone. This is known as instructions. This is like a meta prompt for your whole Copilot. This is where you can give it instructions on whether you want it to be a friendly or formal tone, whether you want it to provide lengthy or quite short, sharp answers. And you can even do things like asking it to use emojis or a certain type of language. I've seen people demo this saying, talk like a pirate, which I don't think would work in a real business scenario, but that is a thing that you can absolutely do. So let's come in here and give it a nice tone here just to save myself some typing. You have a friendly and reassuring tone. Use simple language, break down information into bullet points, and use emojis. Now, watch what's happening on the right-hand side of the screen as we build this out here. You'll see it's sort of keeping track of the information, and it switched then. First thing it did, it's given it a name called Health Advisor based on the purpose I gave it at the start. And then it has actually started to build out those instructions. So it's taken the purpose as well as that specific instruction about how I want it to answer. Where should the Copilot find information? So this is starting off by prompting you to start with a public website as a knowledge source. You don't have to do this. You can just say, skip this or no knowledge. But if you want to get started, picking a public website that's very information rich, anything that's like a public service, things like public transport, universities, health services, those types of places can be really good examples of things that have, you want something that has a lot of information in it. Use your business website, but if it's just like a marketing website, especially something with lots of JavaScript or jargony language, you're not going to get a great result out of that. So let's pop that in here to start with. You can give your Copilot other knowledge sources, which we'll cover in the next video, but using this wizard, not even sure if it's a wizard, this Copilot experience, you can only put in the website at this stage or skip that, but you can come back to it. Great, it's got that in there. Are there any topics or tasks that you shouldn't cover? So this is where you can give it some guardrails around saying that you don't want it to talk about specific things. So in this case, we're going to put in an instruction here to say that we don't want it to be actually doing any diagnosis. This is a health site that sort of explains various health conditions and tips for healthy living, but we don't want it actually acting as a medical practitioner or referring to specific medical practitioners. All right, that's all it is. It gives you the chance to ask other things. So I could put in here and say, actually, don't use emojis or please respond a different way. But for now, you can see that what it's done is put all of that together on the right-hand side there, and we click Create to deploy that. I'm running this one in real time. This will take probably 30 seconds or so. It's not bad. Not even 30 seconds, look at that, to bring that Copilot together. And let's take a look at where all of that information has gone. So firstly, we've got the name Health Advisor, which has come from that upfront purpose of the way that I described it. We're waiting for the description instructions to load. I was a little bit quick. There we go. There's the description that I gave it at the start. There's the instructions for how it all should respond and what it shouldn't do. And then in the knowledge section here, we've got this Better Health website that I just asked it to do earlier. And now we can test it straight away. So let's come in here and say, how do I manage fatigue, which is a topic that is covered on that website. And pretty much instantly, this is going to use generative AI to read that knowledge source, come back with responses. And this is actually a link to that website. If I click through to it, it shows me where that knowledge has come from. Not bad, hey, in under 3 minutes. Now, there are some other things here in terms of creating a Copilot. So let's go back to the start here and click on this create button, and I'll show you a couple of other experiences that you can use. So that experience that I've gone through with the wizard, you can get back to by clicking on create new Copilot, and off we go. But once you've done this a few times, maybe you don't want to start with a website, or you want to start with, you know, not using that experience, you've got a button here where you can just say skip to configure, and you can go ahead and just fill out those details yourself. What do you want the name to be? What is the description of the purpose of this Copilot? What instructions and behavior do you want it to have? And then you can start to add knowledge in there as well. So once you've got this under your belt a bit, you might find that a little bit easier. Let's go back a step, because the other thing I want to show you here is all of these templates. And depending on when you're watching this, you might even see more than this. There's more coming here. You can see quite a lot of things at the time I'm recording this saying coming soon. But let's say I wanted to do something that's an IT help desk. That's a fairly standard one. You can see that this is already pre-populated for you with an icon and a name, the description, the instructions. Having a look at some of these templates is also a really good way to get an idea for what types of things you can put into the instructions here. So you can see that you've got a lot of information about what it can do. It's also giving it language. That's another good thing to put in the instructions. Service requests are also referred to as tickets, cases, or incidents. So anything in your particular domain or industry language is useful to put in there. We've got a pre-built connector ready to go to ServiceNow. You can use your service system of choice. You don't have to use that one. And you can also go ahead and add knowledge in there and create that one and have that same experience. Once you have created that, the next thing you're going to want to do is add more knowledge sources and put good descriptions in for your knowledge. Come and join me in the next video to learn how to do that.